Our next guest today is the CEO of the Philippines' leading crypto and mobile wallet.
That's right, Denise. Joining us today is Mr. Wei Zhou of Coins.ph to discuss their products and more. Good afternoon. Welcome to Business Roadshow, Mr. Zhou.
Thank you very much for having me.
All right. Good to have you here. Now, can you give us a picture of how Filipinos are now adapting to cryptocurrencies? You've been in existence for like 14 years. How has the horizon changed?
Yeah, we've been the leading crypto exchange here in the Philippines, and then we basically have seen a continued push forward in the industry here as our users here in the Philippines continue to use not just to own crypto or to invest into crypto, but actually start to use Web3 services. I think last year, you know, Philippines actually ranked as one of the top five countries in terms of the global crypto adoption by Chain Analysis. So I think net-net, there's a thriving Web3 and crypto community here in the Philippines.
All right, that's quite a jump. Now, you recently offered a crypto program. Tell us a bit about this new affiliate program for corporate and individual traders.
Yeah, so we recently launched an order book exchange that's actually of international standards and actually, you know, with some of the best technology here, I think, industry. So we're really happy to bring that product, Coins Pro, to the to our users here in the Philippines. And as part of our launch, we're actually inviting different affiliates to join the referral network and to, you know, move their users to trade on the Coins Pro. And as a result, you know, we're actually giving out, trading fees or sharing trading fees with our members of the affiliate network. They can get up to, you know, 40 to 60% referral fees if they bring users to trade on the Coins Pro platform.
Well, there is a growing concern about cybersecurity in the crypto industry. What measures and strategies have you implemented, has Coins.ph implemented, I guess, to ensure the security and protection of the digital assets of your users?
I think first of all, I think it's very important to highlight that we're actually fully licensed and regulated by SBSP. So I think we're actually the safest option out there, I think, for local users here in the Philippines. So I think one of the things that's really important for us, in addition to sort of work in terms of bringing international best practices, I think a lot of the team here with Coins have actually been industry veterans. I think not just in the cryptocurrency space, but actually in the internet and the digital banking space, you know, for quite a bit of time. So actually bring a lot of these best practices. But secondly, I think it's really important, I think, to remind users to actually work with regulated businesses here. So that way, you know, if in case anything happens, you know, we actually do have full reserve of our assets. We actually, are audited by our regulators on a regular basis. And we also work pretty closely with the cybercrime investigation unit here to basically prevent, specific frauds, that happen, I think, within the space.
And I know you also offer a wide range of financial services aside from cryptocurrency trading. You know, how does Coins.ph differ, I guess, from traditional banking?
Yeah, I think in addition to being a cryptocurrency and investment app, we actually offer traditional payment services as well. I think with the adoption the push of QRPH, which is a universal payment code that I think all users and all merchants are starting to adopt. I think for Coins, we actually have fully embraced that. And then actually that has allowed for, you know, all of our users to be able to use, to scan and pay. And then for merchants to be able to use funds, I think from our app, as well as I think with other, you know, digital payment services. I think that that's a 24/7 service. You don't need to be for the banking hours to be open for that to be available. And I think the second big thing is for us is actually on the remittance side. I think we have a couple of really big global partnerships that we'll be announcing in the next few weeks, partly at the sort of Philippine Blockchain Week next week, in 2 weeks, that we're co-organizing with the ICT and the Philippine Blockchain Association. So I think, and I think for that one is actually going to be more on the remittance side. I think, you know, blockchain, in addition to sort of being, you know, on 24/7, is actually very low cost and transparent. So we're actually looking forward to announcing that partnership to actually bring, crypto or blockchain-enabled remittance product into the country as well.
All right, you're talking about remittances. That is quite a big market. So let's talk about growth now. How many more users do you have currently? What kind of growth, perhaps, are you seeing in terms of adoption to crypto in the Philippines?
Yeah, I think right now, cumulatively on our platform, we have about over, 15 million registered users. Mm-hmm. And then, on our platform right now, I think over the last year and a half, we've actually been continuing to add, investment products on the crypto side. So I think, so despite being, us being in a, I would say a pretty bear market on cryptocurrency, I think if you look at sort of Bitcoin, Ethereum, those prices are trading at, less than half of where they were during the peak, during the bull market in 2021. So I think, but I think, at the end of the day, I think, we are actually seeing, more interest in this product and more interest, I think, not just from retail users, but actually from institutional users, institutional investors for Bitcoin, Ethereum, and sort of long tail of crypto products that are coming along. In terms of user growth on our platform, we've actually sort of, I would say, saw the bottom of the bear market in terms of user activity at the beginning of this year, near the end of sort of last year. Mm-hmm. And we basically have seen sort of user activity double off of that low. And we expect that that interest to continue to grow as we go into sort of, two major catalyst events for Bitcoin. One is the halving that's happening in May of next year, as well as, I think, the approval for Bitcoin spot ETF in the U.S., that could either come as soon as this month or as, maybe even first half of next year. I think all of those would be positive catalysts, for Bitcoin prices and I think for the cryptocurrency industry as a whole.
And what can you advise someone who wants to begin his own crypto journey in the Philippines?
Yeah, I mean, I think one thing that we've advised people to do is actually, first of all, definitely look at the platform you're trading on. And we recommend, you sort of look at CoinsPH. As I think the easiest thing to do is basically download our app in the App Store. Sign up and then either link your wallet or your bank account and basically get your journey started.
Question and bye bye.
Now, Wei, cryptocurrency markets are really known for volatility. So many people have experienced that. I mean, during the pandemic, how do you manage risk and ensure stability for users, especially during times of extreme price fluctuations, which is nothing new in the crypto mm-hmm. ecosystem?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a couple of points I would like to make here. I think, first of all, it is a risk asset, right? It's not a, it's not a bank deposit. It is something that, so only invest what you're, what you will lose, right? So I think that's one of the sort of the key things about investing. And I think, especially for new users, definitely do the research. I think for coins, we do bring, we scan the coins that we list in terms of we actually know the background of the tokens that we list. We actually have a very rigorous process in terms of looking at it. So I would definitely, look at, platforms that are regulated and that have a certain level of trust, have been building a certain level of trust with the, with the industry and with the users over a time period.
So
in terms of looking at specific assets. In terms of specific assets, like I mentioned before, I think we do see sort of like this 4 to 5 year sort of trend in terms of the Bitcoin halving cycle that has been sort of a major driver for price of not just Bitcoin, but I think the overall industry. I think in terms of overall industry, Bitcoin is the big sort of, big centerpiece with $600 billion worth of market cap today, with the overall crypto industry, I think, only worth about $1 trillion. So I think, whatever happens in Bitcoin will have ramifications, I think, for the rest of the market. And I think, you have to know where you are in the trend. I think people that sort of came into the market in 2021, that was actually, looking back on it, the top of the market. And looking at the market today, I think we're actually nearing bottom, we're hovering at bottom.
Now, in terms of international expansion, what considerations do you have in entering new markets and any regions that you're looking particularly with interest?
Yeah, I think right now we are of single focus CoinsPH in the Philippines right now, but we would like to expand our presence into Southeast Asia. Another market that we currently have a license to operate in is Thailand. So that's a market that we're actively looking at, as well as I think some of the other regions, other markets in Southeast Asia and Asia Pacific as well.
Wei Zhou of CoinsPH, Wei, thank you so much for joining us here in the Business Roadshow.
Sure, thank you for having me.